Multimedia in terms of not being an academic conversation, although I'm primarily an academic, but today everyone is an artist, right? So I'm also trying to be one. And that's why I have an installation in the Biennale, my very first, let me admit. So in a sense, this is, we're seeing how the concept of Riyaz can be excavated, can be re-examined, can be reinvigorated and taken forward in different kinds of musical practice and other artistic practice. And maybe it would be really interesting one day, Johnson, to bring the concept of Riyaz into academic locations as well. In scholarly traditions, what does it mean to do Riyaz? Okay? So this is the project I'm thinking about right now, and in the next couple of years, I want to take forward some sort of understanding of how learning practices work in many kinds of genres, including, of course, North Indian classical music that I have a great attachment to and familiarity with, but maybe also other forms like the Kwinchu in Shanghai and Suzhou, maybe the Cantonese opera in Hong Kong where I'm now based, and other forms that we might decide to work with. So I think this is a broad concept. What is Riyaz? What is learning practice? What is the experience of learning? This is what we have been exploring the last 3 days, and this is what the installation also explores. But to give you a sense, today we thought, because this is a largely unfamiliar audience, or it's an audience of music lovers and people who like music, we thought we would begin by presenting just one of the melodic forms, or translated Gnosis form is the raga. The raga is the melodic form that is customarily used in Indian music, and it's a particular combination of notes. So what we're going to do after the translation has been done, is to take one raga called Yaman, and demonstrate 3 different forms of North Indian classical music in Yaman. More than this, the individual singers will explain before they start singing. Sorry, this has been long, but you know the content, so you can give a summary translation.
首先我想代表所有的出色的印度音乐家朋友来感谢今天的主持人，他今天我们的主人他举办了这样一种活动，在我们印度称作家庭音乐会。那么家庭音乐会这样的形式就代表着大家都是对艺术有所了解和有所追求的人。昨天我们在上海音乐学院介绍了印度音乐的一些基本的方面，包括它这些旋律的构成和节奏的构成，但是我们认为这种基础性的介绍不适合今天这种有层次的观众，所以我们今天来不仅仅是为了表演，而是有以下几个更多的层面。第一，就是一种学术交流，在不同的音乐和背后的文化之间的学术交流。第二，是在这些文化之间创造一个联系性，以为在这种不同的表演，为不同的表演形式搭建一个共同的平台，也为其他的表演形式对我们这种艺术形式的输入提供可能性。那我们这个项目在外面有一个屏幕上播出的这个装置艺术的名字叫 Riyaz， 它是来自波斯语的一个单词，意思是练习，也有冥想等等的一种意思。那这个项目首先是上海双年展展出的，所以那个其中也录到了我们几位音乐家，鲁图加拉这位，还有就是拉里老这位。我们希望大家可以在片子中看到他们的身影。那这刚才讲的这种 Riyaz， 它是一种这种练习，有的时候是自己一个人的，而有的时候是跟老师在一起，老师被他们尊称为咕噜。而最奇特的一种形式就是，有的时候老师他尽管在空间里，但是他并不会专门去听你的唱。所以我想我们的装置艺术就是实现了这样一种对空间的塑造。所以我们这种 Riyaz 的概念也不仅仅是为了学术的，而是希望能在其他的多种艺术形式之中实现这样一种冥想空间的构造。就像我们未来几年可能会做比如广东音乐和像今天昆曲这样的各种各样不同的制作，在我们的 CD 和电影之中也追求同样的一个主题。那在今天正式印度音乐展演的开始，我想先介绍一个最惯用的旋律体系，名字叫 Raga。 Raga 它是一些音符的组合，
we have already mentioned the names of the singers, the two singers. Let me just do one round of introduction again. You don't have to translate, I'm just mentioning the names of the performers. In the center is Pandita Lalit Rao from the Agra Gharana or the Agra style of singing. Here is Omkar Havaldar on my left. Omkar is also currently my own teacher. I'm very happy that he's here. He's from the Kirana Gharana or the Kirana style of singing Indian music. There is Rutuja Lad, our youngest performer, who's from the Jaipur Gharana or the Jaipur style of performing. They have not performed together before. They know each other, but they don't know each other that well. And it's been amazing to see how they could work together in the last few days. And I think you'll see there'll be quite a treat for you towards the end of this, not exactly towards the end, but maybe in the second half of today's performance, where they will actually collaboratively improvise on something. And you will see how the representation of Indian music actually works. I won't say anything more, I just want to say that please note that no one has any sheet or score in front of them. No one is reading off the music. No one has memorized the music. They are all going to improvise. What are the consequences of this and why this is the centerpiece of Indian music, we can discuss later.
So I want to introduce today's three musicians. Sitting in the middle is Ali Lam. His current style is Agra. The style of this word is called Gharana. So his style is Agra Gharana. 而这位男音乐家他叫 Omkar Havaldar， 他所在的流派叫 Kirana Gharana。 这位我们最年轻的女艺术家名字叫 Rutuja Lad， 她的流派是 Jaipur Gharana。 那么他们三位我们看到来自不同的流派，在之前我们这个项目之前也从来没有一起合作过，所以我很想知道这几天的合作能带给他们什么样的这样的一个产出。那么 我们也只想提醒大家注意一点，他们面前没有舞摆，任何形式的乐谱，他们也不是在背谱，而只是一种完全的即兴。在今天我们印度音乐的这部分展演之后，也将跟其他的音乐共同来即兴。那这种即兴所造成的结果，我们将过后探讨。
So we begin with the Pandita Lalit Rao singing the Rag Yaman with the Dhrupad that she's going to present. She will say a couple of words about the Dhrupad before she begins.
她将演唱的这个是印度音乐一个最古老的形式叫 Dhrupad， 它是一个只用了几个单词来进行即兴的这样一种歌唱形式。
On behalf of all three of us, I would like to thank Mr. Johnson Chan for giving us this beautiful stage to perform. Tejaswani, who has been instrumental in getting us here, and to the West Havens Project, through whom we have come here, and to all of you, I hope you will be able to take back, even if you take back a small memory of what we sing today, we would have been successful.
首先我想代表我们三位来感谢今天我们的主人为我们提供这么好的表演条件，还有这么好的设施。然后我也想感谢在座的各位，如果你们能记住任何一点我们所唱的，那就是我们的成功。
I will begin the concert with the Rag Yaman. When I say Rag, it means a melody. The melody becomes the bass and there are small words which form the song. I will be demonstrating the oldest style of North Indian music present today, which is being performed, called Dhrupad Dhamar. Here the rag or melody is elaborated without an accompaniment, followed by a composition which is set to 12, 14 or 10 beats as composed. There is not much scope for imagination or creation in this.
所以今天我想先介绍的这个Raga，它是一个旋律基础，这种像刚才所说的，这是现存最古老的印度古典音乐形式叫Dhrupad。 它是并没有其他乐器来伴奏的。在一个自由的引子之后，是一个以十二拍、十四拍或十拍为旋为这个节奏循环的这样一个创作的作品。
The sound that you're hearing is the drone that accompanies us always. It gives us the bass or the tonic note, Do, which we use as the bass for singing.
现在大家听到的这个弦乐的持续音，就是给我们，将会一直伴随着我们演唱的过程。它为我们所唱的这个音阶提供了主音，就是我们所说的Do。
Mm-hmm.
space, it continues for about half an hour, where you elaborate the whole melody in detail, but I'm cutting it short. Then you go to the double the speed. I will be doing that.
刚才这样的氛围和步调将会持续大约半个小时，来为后面的这个音乐创造一个氛围。那今天我们就简短的把它展示到这儿，接下来那一段音乐的速度将会加倍。
Nature.
接下来就是在即兴的这个影子之后的这个创作作品，它的名字叫这个题材的名字叫 Bandish， 它的内容往往是对神的奉献或对自然的描绘。
In a very different form. The Drupad that you heard from Lalit Rao is one of the oldest forms of North Indian music. It goes back several hundred years. No one knows its origins. But the Khayal, which Omkar will demonstrate now, is approximately 200 or 250 years old. It sort of began as a departure from the Drupad to allow for more flexibility, more innovation, and more improvisation. And Khayal literally means imagination or thought, as Omkar says.
刚才听到的这个 Drupa 是印度最现存最古老的古典音乐题材，大约可以追溯到700年前，并且没有人知道它的根源。那么接下来我请 Omkar 唱的这个流派，这个类型叫 Kaya， 它的意思是想象，大约是在200到250年前从最古老的 Drupa 形式衍生出来的。它为即兴、自由和这个弹性提供了更多的空间。那现在要唱的是同一首吧。
I will now be demonstrating the Khayal format of Hindustani classical vocal music. Khayal, as Dr. Tejaswini said, is imagination or thought of a musician who expresses in the particular raga that he or she is singing.
就像刚才介绍过的 Khayal 这个词是音乐中的想象或者思想，是表现了这一个人在唱歌之中的所想。
In Khayal, we have 3 divisions. The first division is a Bada Khayal or a big composition, which is sung in a slower tempo. It's called Vilandit.
这个 Khayal 音乐它分为三部分，第一部分是一个又长又缓慢的这样一个创作的部分。
The second section is the Mandhale or the medium tempo, where the composition is presented in a short span of time.
第二部分的中间部分的速度是适中的，它所持续的时间也是最短的。
The third part is the Drut or the faster tempo, where the composition is presented very quickly in a faster tempo.
第三部分是快速呈现的这么一首作品。
Since we have limited time today, I will present the medium tempo and also slightly fast tempo here.
因为今天时间有限，我将展示的是中间这段中速的部分和一点快速的部分。神吹笛子的场景。
And how everybody is mesmerized listening to Lord Krishna's music over the flute, and everybody is gathered around to listen to him.
也是所有的听众都聚集在他身边，被他的笛声所迷陶醉。
And the poet at the end wishes that he was also part of the celebration. It is all in the minds of the poet. So everybody is has gathered to celebrate Krishna's music, and the poet wishes, how I wish I was a part of it.
但是事实上，这个场景都是出自诗人的想象。那诗人在最后描述说，我多希望我也能是这个场景的一部分。
Seven and nine,
on the first movement of the notes, a combination of notes. So we have this seven notes in the in this particular melody, which is so I use this notes and make combinations of them. So something like this. So I can take any note in this. It's slow tempo. If I sing the same thing in the fast tempo. If I sing the same thing in aka, where I don't necessarily pronounce the notes, but I sing the notes in the form of a, which is. So here, I take this combination and let my mind very free, and I let my mind take me wherever it goes, but within the structure of raga. So just for our understanding, I have seen both in notation and in other. So now I'm pretty sure you get the idea. So I'll not sing the notation, I'll just sing it in another.
A light classical form. This is from the musical theater of the 19th century, which has lasted to this day, but sort of died out in a major way in the 1930s. This was in the language Marathi, unlike the other compositions that were sung in Hindustani. And it was through the musical theater, this is what I've been researching in the last few years, through the musical theater, the melodies of North Indian music became extremely popular amongst a wide range of people who then were very keen to learn the music themselves.
接下来最后一个想要介绍的题材就叫朱拉，它是一个比较轻音乐式的传统音乐的题材，大约诞生在二十世纪的大约1930年这个年代，随着当时的一些音乐戏剧的流行，那古典印度声乐的一些旋律变得非常的流行，那这也是我这几年在做的一项研究。
Hello, I am singing a song from a musical play. The song describes the journey of a seeker who wants to find the ultimate path towards God. He travels the Himalayas and tries to find the way to God.
我想。